हेलो वेलकम बैक माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 11th। डियर स्टूडेंट आई एम राजेंद्र राय योर बायोलॉजी टीचर एंड प्रेजेंटिंग दिस वीडियो फॉर योर लर्निंग। माय डियर स्टूडेंट टुडे आई विल टेक द टॉपिक दैट इज द नॉन कॉर्डेटा। डियर स्टूडेंट इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो यू हैव लर्न सो मेनी थिंग्स about the cordata, their classes, their super classes, and now we will discuss non-cordata. Non-cordata means the non-cordates, they don't have the notochord. So on the basis of the presence or absence of the notochord, the whole animal kingdom get divided into two groups. If the notochord is absent, then they are called non-cordata. And if notochord is present and extended up to the vertebral column, then that will be the cordata or vertebrata. My dear student, in the non-cordata, several phylums are there, which are including primitive animals as well as the some more advanced non-cordates. And the phylums of the non-cordata are phylum Porifera, phylum Coelenterata or Cnidaria, then phylum Platyhelminthes, phylum Schelminthes, phylum Annelida, phylum Mollusca, phylum Echinodermata, and last but not least Hemicordata. So these are the different phylums, and then after phylum Chordata. These are the different phylums which are phylum Chordata. That is why they must be separated from the these non-chordates. This is the confusion in between the this explanation of the classification of animal kingdom. There should be no confusion. एक तरफ आप non-chordata बोल रहे हैं, एक तरफ बोल रहे हैं Chordata is the phylum of the non-chordate. So that is the controversy. So avoid this controversy. Let us classify the animal kingdom into two groups, non-cordata and cordata, no, invertebrata and vertebrata. That's all, enough. No any controversy should be there regarding this. And let us discuss the number one phylum, that is the phylum Porifera. So let us start Phylum Porifera. So, phylum Porifera are the primitive animals and their organizations are of cellular level. They are having the cellular level of organization and As far as their body design is concerned, they are having the either cylindrical body or flattened body. So this is cyphon. And the Porifera's are having the pore on their dermal layer. They are having the pores on their dermal layer. These pores are called ostia. And this is called osculum. So my dear student, this is cyphon. This is the cyphon, and that is the primitive animal, that is the primitive non-cordate. therefore, as far as the characteristics of these phylum Porifera is concerned, you have to mention the characteristics of the phylum Porifera like number one, the Poriferans have cellular level of organization, cellular level of organization. So their body designed with the at the cellular level, and the cells which perform different functions in these poriferans are called coenocytes. So second, coenocytes are formed to perform different functions. इसमें जो सेल्स होती हैं डिफरेंट फंक्शंस इसमें जो सेल्स होती हैं दे आर कॉल्ड एज कोइनोसाइट्स. सो व्हाई डू स्टूडेंट्स हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस कोइनोसाइट्स,
दैट कोइनोसाइट्स आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर परफॉर्मिंग डिफरेंट फंक्शंस इन द पोरिफेरेंस. ओके,
three pores or ostia. Pores or ostia are found on their dermal layer. On their outer dermal layer, here to indicate the outer. On their outer dermal layer.
My dear student, next is, these pores facilitate the incoming of the water. The pores facilitate the incoming of the water so that water can come inside the body, inside the cavity of this body cavity of this poriferan, and along with the water current, several other food particles will come inside. And the coenocytes, they perform the process of digestion, absorption, secretion, respiration, everything that will be done by the coenocytes. And later on, the excretory substances along with the water stream, that will be come out from this osculum.
So water current will come through this. Water will come through this and internally body cavity, and then after that water goes outside as the excretory substance.
My dear students,
body four.
Osculum present.
Osculum
going, outgoing of water and metabolic wastes and metabolic wastes.
So osculum is present. This is the osculum that is the present, so that the metabolic waste and other material will be go out.
And come to next, that is the fifth, and fifth is body asymmetrical body, asymmetry asymmetrical body, asymmetrical body.
Several other examples are also there, my dear student. This is cycle, and other examples are so some other animals, they will have their body structure something like this. My dear students, you are looking here the several characteristics of the porifera.
This is eusponia. This is eusponia. Eusponia. This is eusponia.
So students, you are looking here about the different characters, different types of the other characters that is present in the phylum Porifera. And examples are the cycon, eusponia, and spongilla. They are hermaphrodite. They are having spicules,
six spicules are found, on their body. They are hermaphrodite. They are hermaphrodite, means male and female are in the same. Internal fertilization and asexual reproduction, they reproduce asexually,
and if they will be the, they will perform the sexual reproduction, then there will be the formation of gamete, and they will be able to fuse the gametes inside their body. So that is why they will perform the internal fertilization. So my dear student, thank you very much for your watching this video. I hope that you will like this video, and if you like this video, please subscribe my channel. Thank you. Have a good day.